praising him. Lift your voices up and say, thank you, Jesus. Say, thank you, Jesus. Now clap your hands, all you people. The Bible stands. The Bible stands, amen? Amen. We're going into a little bit of praise and worship right now. Is that all right?
Hallelujah.
Is that all right? My hallelujah belongs to you.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is good. Amen. God is good. Amen. Hallelujah. He's brought us a mighty long way. Hallelujah. He's brought us a mighty long way. Hallelujah. He's kept us yet through another year. Hallelujah. For some of us, it was trying. We felt like giving up. But thank God, we pressed on. Hallelujah. So let's give God some praise one more time. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Everyone, students, family, friends, faculty, welcome to this, our 37th commencement exercises. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. God has truly been faithful to this school. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's enough to give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One man had a vision, and then another man catched a vision and ran with the vision. So we got to give God praise. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. At this time, I'm going to invite Dr. Beverly Jones, and she's going to come and do the scripture reading. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord again, for he is worthy to be praised. Amen. Our scripture reading this morning is taken from Ephesians 4, verses 11 through 16. And it reads, "And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into the things, into all things, which is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body, fitted jointly together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, making increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love." Here endeth the reading. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. At this time, I'm going to invite Pastor Agard, and he's going to come and do the invocation. Gentlemen, please take your caps off for prayer.
Thank you very much indeed. And this is a great day of rejoicing. Amen. The Word of God tells us that better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. Amen. And for you graduates, you have come to the end. But don't take it as the end. You've only been brought to another level to keep going on. So don't give up, but keep pressing on with the Word of God. Shall we pray? Our loving Father, we praise and we exalt your glorious name. We can truly say today this is the day that you've made. Yes. And Father, we are rejoicing. Yes. And we are glad for all that you've done. And for what you've done this day, Father, we will never cease to praise you. You are worthy from the rising of the sun till the going down thereof to be praised at all times and in all places. We thank you this morning for CBI, yes, and for this 37th and graduation ceremony. Yes. We give you thanks this morning for those who laid the foundation. Yes. We can never forget them, Father.
Yes.
And we thank you that it's only because of your doing
yes.
that we are still here after 37 years.
Yes.
We pray, Father, for those who have taken up the mantle and who are currently carrying on this work. We thank you for Apostle Denson. We thank you, oh Father, for all the staff that is working with him. And we pray, oh God, that you'll just equip them, prepare them, strengthen them, that they will never become weary in well-doing. For, oh God, the task that you have given them is a mighty one. It is to carry on and perpetuate the Bible, the book that stands forever. The book that is settled in heaven. The book, oh God, which no man can change. But, oh God, it brings joy and peace to our aching hearts. We thank you this morning for every instructor at CBI. For their commitment, oh God, for what they've done over the years and continue to do. We pray, Father, you'll just give them the grace never to become weary in well-doing, never to give up, but to encourage each other and themselves be encouraged in the Lord so that this work will continue until you come. We thank you for every student today, O God. Those who are graduating at different levels, O God, give them the grace, O Father, to continue. Help them, Father, to know that in this life, we go from stage to stage. And truly, O God, we will never graduate to say that we are finished. But rather, O God, that we'll be equipped to constantly serve you under all circumstances and in all places. Help the students, O God, and staff alike, that we will never become discouraged. There are times, O God, when many of these students felt discouraged even to come on a snowy day, even to come after work. But, oh God, you sustained and kept them.
Yes.
And you'll be faithful to all of your people at all times. We thank you that we've come to this day of rejoicing, a day of victory for which we give you thanks. We pray this morning for our speaker, Pastor Carson, Lord, and we pray, oh God, that you will, Father, just give her a word to challenge everyone today.
Amen.
And that we'll go on to serve you as we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. At this time, I'm going to invite the salutatorian to come. Sister Patricia Saunders. Let's put our hands together and bless the Lord as she comes.
Greetings, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Giving honor to President Dr. William J. Denson, Registrar Dr. Mamie Green Archer, Senior Pastor Jacqueline Barksdale, our commencement speaker, Reverend Arlise Carson, faculty, graduates, and invited guests. We welcome you to our 36th commencement exercise. Thank you, Lord. Excuse me, 37th. I am excited. It's a great year. Every year is great. Amen. Come on, give God a praise. Because he is an on-time God. Amen. Amen. The Bible states, in 2 Timothy 2:15. Help me, classmates. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Amen. God is good. God is a good God. And we have been equipped, my fellow students, we have been equipped in the Word of God here at CBI. As we gather here to celebrate these months of hard work and learning, we are blessed by the teachers and how they have accurately divided the Word of God and inspired us as we study the infallible Word of God. We, the students at Community Bible Institute and Seminary, have come this far by faith. So let us rejoice, knowing that the joy of the Lord is our strength. The Bible states in Matthew 5:6, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Be encouraged and thank the Holy Spirit for equipping us to stand strong through another year of Bible school. And remember, God keeps his promises. We are blessed and we are equipped.
Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, Sister Patricia. Amen. At this time, we're going to have selection. Selection by the CBI choir. Let's put our hands together and welcome them.
Amen. Put your hands together, everybody. We're going to ask Sister Janice, come on down. Amen. This young lady, we do give honor to our president. Amen. Our Dr. Archer. Amen. Our Pastor Barksdale. And to a quorum of professors and doctors and teachers and to our guest speaker, amen, and to the class of this year, 2017, graduation class. Come on and make some noise more than that. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We thank God. We thank God. I'm going to come this way because I know that y'all can't see me from this side, and I've got to face this side. But I thank God because God is good. He's wonderful. Amen. How many of you know he's wonderful? In the midst of sorrow, he's still wonderful. In the midst of heartaches, he's still wonderful. In the midst of emergency surgery, he's still wonderful. A miracle. A miracle. A miracle. I think it was about a month ago when this happened. A month ago, and I went to Apostle Denson and told everybody, and I needed them to pray. Well, he told me to take the picture, find her picture on my phone. This was in chapel class. Find her picture on your phone. And we're going to go before the throne of grace. And I'm going to tell you, that prayer, hallelujah, we couldn't even get out of chapel. That prayer was so effective. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The young lady that I'm talking about is my cousin. We're cousin sisters. And she's sitting on the front row. I don't know if she's able to stand, but she's here. Emergency heart surgery. A month ago, she could have died. Her heart was working 40%. 40%. And she was in school. Nobody knew it. But God. But God. But God. But God. But God.
Hallelujah.
I'm trying to hold myself. And I know that she can't shout now. And I told them I was so emotional. The death of my sister, the operation of my cousin. We was in the operating room for 7.5 hours with her. She didn't know. She was so under. But I thanked me unto God because I have another cousin that is in the nursing profession. And she looked at that thing and she started telling us and explaining to us what was going on. But I thank God for being in high places. Thank God for being in high places. So if you're looking for a miracle, if you want to see a miracle, look over this way. Because that's the miracle of today. That's the miracle of today. She's the miracle of today. She is the miracle of today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We're fighting every day. This is war. This is war, people. We're fighting every day. We can't take this sitting down. We gotta stand up and fight. We gotta fight for our rights. This young lady told me I can't sing. But guess what? She's singing. So we're gonna go forth. This is war. Come on, musicians. I need y'all to put your hands together. Come on, do it like this. This side, come on.
I'm not afraid to die.
Hallelujah. We declare war against the enemy. Amen. Hallelujah. He can't have our families. Hallelujah. He can't have our increase. Hallelujah. He can't have it. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. You know one thing the devil can't pass over is the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise God. This is a Bible school, amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. We don't just teach scripture, but we see the scripture manifested, amen? We see what we teach manifest. Hallelujah. And in spite of all that we may have been going through, this is a testimony, and I'm going to give our sister Yvette Short a minute to just testify about the goodness of God, amen? Hallelujah. Let's encourage her. Praise God. I didn't know what was going on. I missed her, and I was asking for her. I asked her cousin last week for her, but I'm glad she's here. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Sometimes you just get a toothache, and you're ready to give up. Your foot started hurting, and you're ready to give up. But she had heart surgery, and here she is. Amen. Pressing on. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. God, I thank you, God. Oh, God, I just give you praise right now. Oh, God, I don't even know where to start because it's just so much. But all I know is that God just had this thing orchestrated from step one. Because I don't even know where it started, but we were in school here. And Pastor Denson got up. It was supposed to be some people speaking, but they didn't make it. And Pastor Denson got up, and he told us to repeat that we will not leave this place the same way that we came. And then after he finished that, he came out and he said, this is the year that God is going to show himself mighty. He said, some of you are going to see a miracle. And some of you are going to be the miracle. And God knows I didn't expect to be the miracle, but here I am. All I heard was the doctor say that I had 40% of life left in my heart. And my God, where's Nisi? Stand up. If my cousin hadn't been near the doctor, she came in. Those people left me in the hospital in the emergency room with my heart bleeding for how many hours? It was a whole entire day. And they told me that it wasn't a heart, it wasn't a stroke, that it was nothing they could do. But God sent my cousin from work, and she came straight in. And when she came in, she told him, she said, what are you doing? There is no way she's in this much pain, and it's not her heart. Long story short, she told them what to do, and it was God. They turned around, and they said, well, we can't send her to whatever place it was because they would have to make arrangements because other people go in. Well, God, I tell you, was right there because coming down the aisle was two young ladies, and they saw my son, and they said, Lance, what are you doing here? He said, my mother needs to go, whatever. They said, oh, really? Well, I'm taking her in right now. God took me in. All I can tell you is that the operation, it just went beyond what the doctors was even saying. I went in. All I know is after I operated, my daughter showed me a picture of how I swelled up so big. And to show you how great my God is, how many hours was it before I was down, Shay? I was down about 6 hours. Ramona, I went down from the swelling. The next day, I was walking. The next day, I was getting up and I was eating. The next day, I was laughing. The next day, the doctor was telling me that I was going to the rehabilitation center. I looked at the doctor and said, I don't receive that. The devil is a liar. He said, you calling me the devil? I said, no, but I don't receive those words. And within 3 days, I walked out of the hospital from having an artillery, what do you call it, Nee? An aorta dissection. They had to put me on ice. What was it again? They're telling me 19 degrees. And they said that they had to bring my heart back up slowly, because if they didn't, my heart was going to bleed out. But God had everything set up. And I'm home, y'all. And I heard Pastor Denson said that he decree and declare that I was going to be here in this graduation. Well, I want y'all to see, not only am I here, but I'm walking, I'm talking, I'm praising my God. And I thank God for what he's done for me, okay? And I want y'all to look at this miracle, because if God did it for me, he can do it for you. Is there anything too hard for God? Is there anything too hard for God? Is there anything? No, it's not. Give that big God praise.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God. My God. Is there anything too hard for God to do? Hallelujah. We serve a great, big, wonderful God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. This time, we're going to invite the valedictorian to come forth, Sister Joan Rowe. Let's put our hands together and bless the Lord as she comes. Hallelujah. Come on, Sister Joan. Let's bless the Lord one more time.
Thank you. To God be the glory. Great things he hath done. I give honor to God, to whom all honor is due. To the president, Dr. William J. Denson, to the registrar, Dr. Mamie Green Archer, to my instructors, Dr. Sylvina Chavis and Dr. Horace John, to the faculty, guest speaker, student body, families, friends, I greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are here today to celebrate what the Lord has done. He has done great things. Whereof we are glad. Let us give God a shout out for his marvelous work. Hallelujah. 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 I entreat you to reflect on the journey that brought you here. There were long days, sleepless nights, reading, writing, and assessments through sunshine, rain, and snow. God was our guide, and our inspiration was our school scripture, 2 Timothy
2:15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. 2 Timothy 2:15. Amen. Additionally, I encourage you to recognize the effort of your family and friends who help you to remain focused, strong, and courageous. Mom, sis, son, and my church family, bless you. The road travel to arrive at this destination was worth taking. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow once said, "The heights that great men reached and kept were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, kept toiling upward through the night." When I first heard of community Bible school and seminary, I said I did not have the time, and the finance was not there. Furthermore, it was too far. However, I had a tremendous yearning to study the Word of God. And God worked on the desire of my heart by allowing me to attend CBI, Faith Dynamics with instructor evangelist Irene Allen, was my first class. It was love at first bite. Faith pervades our discussion with evidence from Genesis to Revelation and from our own experiences. Indeed, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Faith class whet my appetite, and I knew then that I wanted more of what CBI had to offer. Another class that truly impacted me was the Holy Spirit and His Gift with Elder Jacqueline Farrell. Through scriptures and discussion, I learned much about who the Holy Spirit is and what He does. The Holy Spirit is God Himself alive within our soul. The word was rightly divided with Bible portions for me to chew on, and knowledge gleaned in this class deepened my understanding of the Holy Spirit's operation in my life and brought me into a more intimate relationship with God. And there was Bible Survey with Evangelist Dorothy Risha and Dr. Wayne Scott. We examined the Bible book by book. We studied scriptures, messages, characters, and events in their historical sequences, as well as their contemporary applications. Dr. Scott, you too had been a student at CBI. You have truly inspired me. Your achievements, your humility, and most of all, your testimony of God's enduring mercy and everlasting love. Hashtag God's enduring mercy and everlasting love. In addition, I must recognize my instructor, Dr. Denson, in praying with a purpose for the depth to which he took us as we delved into scriptures and affirmed the power of prayer. Dr. Denson, you admonished us continually not to just study scriptures and memorize them, but to meditate on them, which will in turn improve our ability to pray effectively using the Word of God. Likewise, I acknowledge Dr. Robert Thomas, Sr., and Dr. Mamie Green Archer for their invaluable support with my thesis. Finally, I would not be giving this speech without the master's class, with instructors who complement each other. Well, Dr. Chavis, who is content-driven, and Dr. John, who is driven by content. In Dr. Chavis's class, we read, researched, and discussed everything, or so it seemed, that deals with theology, the definition and existence of God, the study of angels, the study of human and their relationship to God, the study of Christ the Messiah, and the list goes on. Dr. John introduced me to apologetics, more importantly, Christian apologetics. Dr. John, when I first came to your class 2 years ago, we were at loggerhead with many issues. For example, truth versus fact. I must admit, then my explanation of truth was according to worldly definition. But today, I stand corrected. Truth is absolute and stands every test absolutely. Dr. John, you trained me well. My CBI family and friends, I couldn't have made it to graduation without you. You prayed with and for me. You assisted me in many ways. Thank you. Pastor Andrea Smith, Elder Xavier Saunders, and Sister Coralie Maglashan, your advice, encouragement, and kind-heartedness kept me focused and steadfast. Thank you. By far, Thursday night chapel was my favorite. I looked forward to the worship, the fellowship, and the table spread with spiritual food. I ate well, and I grew strong. There was always enough for me, and leftovers I would share with families and friends. On behalf of the CBI graduating class of 2017, I express gratitude to all our instructors who had been obedient to the calling of God and had taught us in theology and trained us in ministry. We appreciate your sacrifice, your love, your humility, your compassion. In all our classes, you allowed the Holy Spirit to be the master teacher and guide. We are blessed and highly favored to have learned from you. My CBI experience has left an indelible mark on my mind. Graduates, I hope it has done the same for you. I have grown in wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of things concerning Christ. Bible school education is much more than getting what we can and canning what we get. We know a good Bible school education, that which we got from CBI, will never decay. CBI graduates, we have come to an important part of the journey. Now, where do we go from here? Wherever we go, we must demonstrate our love of God and love as Christ has asked us to love. And we must help others as we travel along. Also, we must live the life God had called us to live. Finally, we must use what we have learned here to help build the kingdom of God. Being confident of this very thing. He which has begun a good work in us will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's bless the Lord for her one more time. Amen, amen. God is good. At this time, going to invite the interrogator for today, Sister Margaret Dixon. She's going to come forward. And her questioners, Sister Jeanette Alston and Sister Curly McGlasher. Come on, you can do better than that. Let's put our hands together and welcome them.
Praise the Lord. Today we'll be coming from the evangelism class. Sister Jeannie Austin, are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Sister Coralie McClushen, are you ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Sister Austin, it is evident that the Bible contains principles of evangelism. Both the message and the method can be found in the scriptures. How would you define evangelism?
Evangelism is a process of reaching people who are without Christ, making them aware of their sins, presenting the gospel to them, and leading them to accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior.
Sister McClushen, according to the scripture, evangelism is the work of every believer. Could you tell us where it first began and what made it necessary?
Genesis 3 and 9 states, "And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? Surely the Almighty, omniscient God knew where Adam was, but he wanted Adam to realize that he was in a lost condition and needed a redeemer. This is where evangelism first begun, in the Garden of Eden. By this, we can see that the lost condition of man has made evangelism very necessary."
Sister Austin, could you tell us what are the qualifications and the evidence of an evangelist?
While the scripture teaches that evangelism is a work of every believer, but every believer is not called to be an evangelist. An evangelist is a divine calling and is anointed for this ministry. Therefore, he must have a clear and vivid concept about the gospel of Christ, a deep love for lost souls, and the capacity for this leadership. The evidence is a deep conviction of God's supreme will, a call that is so clear that it will conflict with everything that the individual undertakes.
Sister McClosha, what is the Bible's view of an evangelist?
The ministry of the evangelist is not a human process, neither is it of one's choosing. It is a gift given to the church by Jesus Christ. Ephesians 4 and 11 states, and it gives some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers. The work of the evangelist is to preach the gospel for the saving of souls. In the book of Romans, the apostle Paul asks the question, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him in whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent?
Amen. Sister Austin, is preparation for the field of evangelism necessary?
Yes, preparation is necessary. 2 Timothy 2:15 states, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly divided the word of truth. The evangelist, therefore, must be able to discern God's will and interpret it to the people.
Amen. Sister McClosha, can you tell us what scripture equips us for evangelism?
In the book of Acts 1 and 8, Jesus told his disciples, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. This ministry cannot be carried out without the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen, amen. Sister Austin, the ministry of Jesus as the evangelist was prophesied by the prophet Isaiah. According to the scripture, there were six things that were to characterize his ministry as evangelist. Can you tell us what were they?
Preach the gospel to the poor, heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captives, recovery of sight to the blind, set at liberty at those who are oppressed, and preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
Amen. Sister McClosha, the evangelist preaches one primary message. Would you tell us what is the message?
In the book of Acts 8 and 5, then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. The message that the evangelist preaches, the good news, the word of God, when it is preached, souls are saved, delivered, and set free. In the book of Acts 4 and 12 states, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given whereby we must be saved.
Finally, Sister Austin and Sister McClashan. The Apostle Paul, while in prison, wrote a second letter to his beloved son, young Timothy. In this letter, he gave him a specific charge. What was it?
Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears.
And they shall turn their ears away from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. But wash thou in all things, endure affliction, do the work of an evangelist, make full proof of thy ministry.
Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Wasn't that good? Wasn't that good? Amen, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God, hallelujah. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, this is a time where all of us can get involved. Amen. Hallelujah. We've come to the part of this service, this sermon, where everybody will get involved. So this time I'm going to invite Dr. Carvina Christopher to come and bless the offering. Prayer for the offering. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Isn't it a blessing to be together as one, unified in the spirit, in the bond of peace? And it's such a privilege to pray for the offering. It's an act of worship, you know that, right? So we are about to worship God by giving of our offering today. And it's a blessing that all of us are going to be involved. Amen? So we are just going to God now. And my prayer is just this, that we bless you, Lord, today. It's a privilege. And so, Lord, we know that all good gifts come from you. And on thine own, we are about to give to you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise the Lord. At this time, Dr. William Denson is going to come and he's going to lead us in the offering. Let's put our hands together and welcome Dr. Denson.
Okay, let's all stand. She's already prayed. Just remember what Jesus said about an offering. Don't even look at your neighbor. Just remember what Jesus said. He says, if you give, he says, if you give, he will cause it to be given back to you. Good measure. Come on. Shaken and running over. I'm not messing with you. I'm just saying this. If you don't give, you don't qualify for that scripture. So if I had a need, I would not give for compulsion, but I would give to try to help my need. Amen? Amen. No give. Leave Luke 6:38 alone. Amen? So you got your offering, right? If you make it out a check, make it out to Community Bible Institute and Seminary. Write it out. If you're making a check, make it out to Community Bible Institute and Seminary. Amen. My wonderful brother. Wow. How you doing? All right. That's good. Okay, everybody face the walls. Face the walls on each side. Face the walls. So you got to face a wall. That's all you got to do is find a wall. Face the walls and starting from the rear, bring your offering. Excuse me, just a minute. What's happening? Oh, so they're not going to bring the offering. They just gonna put it in the bucket.
Put it in the basket.
All right, just put it in the bucket. All right.
Blessing in glory.
It's too much.
No,
I'm not.
Just wanna praise you forever and ever. Done for me. How many of you can say that today? We can say this, graduates. Come on.
Just one.
Yeah.
Ghost.
Yes.
Oh, glory to your name. That's why he keeps on making a way.
Yes.
Over and over again.
Yes.
And he's always bringing me out.
Yes.
Over and over again. He's done so much. And all to him I owe. I will ever sing your praise, Sister Yvonne. Glory to your name, Elder Stewart.
Hallelujah.
He keeps on making a way. Point at yourself.
Hallelujah.
He keeps on making a way.
Yes.
For me.
Yes.
Again, he keeps on making a way. For me.
Yes.
For me.
For me.
For me. No, you're going to say it for yourself. For me.
For me.
Amen. Keeps on making a way. Put your hand on it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He keep on making a way for us. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's the God we serve. He's always making a way for us. Where there seems to be no way, God will always make a way for us. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. At this time, I'm going to invite Pastor Barksdale to come, and she's going to pray for the speaker.
Come on, let's just give God some more praise. Do me a favor and stand just for a minute. Some of you are here today, and I'm going to read the bio of us, of our tremendous woman of God who's with us here today. But some of us are here, and we don't know the history of this school. Just for a moment, and remember, everything has a history. And if you don't really, you're supposed to always honor the history, because you would not be where you are if there was not history. Amen. Community Bible Institute and Seminary was started by a great visionary by the name of Dr. Clarence Johnson. Amen. Come on and just put your hands together and thank God for him. Today would not be here. We would not have this great testimony by this woman of God. Amen. That went into an operating room not even knowing that she was even in there. But she's here to tell you today it was God that was in there and brought her out. There was just so much to talk about him, but today maybe we won't do that. Now, he was followed by Dr. James Copeland. Come on. It was always said that Ciara was always going to make sure you get saved. But Bishop was always going to make sure you grew. Okay? Because CR dealt with us with the tent, but Bishop took us to conferences. Amen. And he was able to do something that was on CR's mind, and that means bringing the church together. If CBI has one distinction out of it, it's not about just a particular part of the body, but it's able to bring all essence of the body together and help us get along. Amen. Amen. Tell somebody, even though we might be different, we can get along. Don't look at me like that now. Everybody in here ain't the same. Come on. We don't even believe the same things in some areas, but we need to learn to get along. Look at somebody, say, learn to get along. We are a body. I said we are a body, and and our body belongs to one head, and he doesn't ever want us not to get along. Now, I want to say this before we bring on this mighty woman of God and have prayer for her. Just look at somebody and say, the only way to get along is to love each other with the love of God. With the love of God. Not with your love, not with my love, not what I think about you, not what somebody else think about you, but the love of God. I will get along with you if I love you with the love of God. If I love you, I'll get along with you. I may not like you, but I'll get along with you. Y'all know me. We have a preacher now. Y'all know me. I ain't gonna give y'all no Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. I'm gonna give you real life experiences. Amen. I'm going to love you with the love of the Lord. Today we have a tremendous woman of God with us. Let's thank God. Come on. Come on. That's by faith. Come on. Come on. We're going to receive from her by faith. She's going to be a blessing to us by faith. In the person of Reverend Arlise Carson, and if I didn't get it right, she can correct me. Reverend Arlise Carson. The Reverend Arlise Carson is a native of Portsmouth, Virginia. She is happily married to the Reverend Tyade Carson, a native of Detroit, Michigan, who she serves with in ministry. The Carson have two beautiful daughters, Bria and Imani. Reverend Arlise graduated from Norfolk State University with a BA in political science pre-law. She received her Master of Professional Studies in Urban Ministry and Master of Divinity from Nyack College Alliance Theological Seminary. She also received her Master's of Science in Education / Special Education. Childhood from Toro College Graduate School of Education and Psychology in New York. She has worked as an elementary principal in Brooklyn, New York, and currently works as an elementary principal in Long Island, New York. Reverend Carson has served with her husband in ministry for over a decade. During this time, she has discovered her greatest passion is to glorify and please God while serving his people and ministering a radically relevant message of salvation, deliverance, uncompromised truth, empowerment, and faithfulness. She and her husband attend and serve at the Greater Allen Cathedral in Jamaica, New York, under the anointed leadership of Pastor Floyd and co-pastor Elaine Flake. Reverend Arlise is a woman that earnestly perseveres to walk in the excellence of God so that she may glorify the Lord in all she does. She has truly been called into this time for God's purpose. She attributes all she is in Christ to the love, grace, and mercy of God that continues to make all things possible in her life. Let's thank God for her. Come on, let's thank God for her. I said, let's thank God for her. At this time, Pastor Jacqueline Barksdale is going to lift her up in prayer.
Amen. Come on, let's give God praise one more time. Hallelujah. We give God praise. We thank you for the woman of God. Father, we ask that you bless her as she stands at this pulpit, oh God, that the anointing will flow freely through her in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now we bind up all activities of the adversary, and we say, speak, Lord, speak, Lord. Speak to our heart, speak to our soul. Let there be deliverance, healing, and salvation. We thank you for how you're going to use her right now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, use her, Lord, and let us point our hands toward her and just say, use her, Lord. Use her, Lord. Use her, Lord. And you will get all the glory and all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We present Reverend Carson.
Amen, amen. Come on and praise our God. Hallelujah. Isn't he worthy to be praised? Doesn't he deserve all the glory and all the honor? Come on, lift up your voices and give him some praise. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter what it looks like. It could be worse. Come on and lift up your voices and give God some praise in the house. We've come to magnify him. We've come to glorify his name. We've come to exalt him. Oh, yes, we have. Come on and bless the name of the Lord our God. Hallelujah to Jesus. Let the devil know that he is a liar. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah to Jesus. Thank you, God, for your grace and your mercy. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We give all honor and glory, hallelujah, to our Father. He is worthy to be praised. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated too, Apostle Denson. Thank you so much for the invitation. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Pastor. I definitely thank you for your hospitality. Hallelujah. And Dr. Archer, she stepped away, but let's give God some praise for her. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And to all of the graduates, what
a wonderful day, amen, to celebrate what God is doing in our midst. Hallelujah. Let's go to the word of the Lord, amen. I'm going to lift up a very familiar text which we have already stated, but I want to put it in the atmosphere again. Ephesians 4, 11 and 12, and if it is your custom to stand, please do so, amen. Amen. Most importantly, when you leave this place, stand for the word of God. Amen. Ephesians 4, verses 11 and 12, reading from the New International Version of Scripture, and this is what the word says. So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and teachers to equip his people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up. Amen. Amen. I would ask that you would pray with and for me as I preach from the topic. Don't lose your fire. Don't lose your fire. God, I thank you so much for your grace and your mercy. I thank you for your loving kindness and your peace. I thank you, God, for being so wonderful this morning. I praise you, God, and ask that you would continue to watch over, God, my pastors, God, my husband, my children, our families, God, in the name of Jesus. God, move in this place as you so desire. God, speak through me, use me for your glory. Every opposing force, every demonic principality, we've taken authority, bound them, and cast them back to the pit from whence they've come. We declare and decree that your word shall go forth with power and strength, and the Holy Spirit shall have his way. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. God, you are awesome. There's nobody like you. God, you are awesome. Nobody can compare. God, you are awesome. Have your way in this place. God, you're awesome. And we give you all the praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Don't lose your fire. On May 2nd, 2017, at 7:03 a.m., I was driving in my car, going to work, and out of nowhere, another car just turned in front of me, and it was a collision. Some would think that you would close your eyes, scream. But prior to the person hitting me, the Holy Spirit spoke and let me know you are about to be hit. He let me know to brace myself. I say that to say that some would think that a car accident would cause you to have your life flash before your eyes. But when you know that your purpose has not yet been fulfilled, hallelujah, you understand that it is just a distraction. When you know that there are some bumps and some collisions and some accidents and some things that may even be unfortunate, you understand that it's just a way that the enemy tries to take to get your attention on him. Come on, somebody. When you understand that even trials and tribulations will cause you to have some pain and some aches, come on up in here. You recognize that God is still with you in the midst of every storm. careful you would allow an accident or some tribulation or some bumps or some knocks or some bruises or even some breakdowns to cause you to feel as if God has forsaken you. Is there somebody up in the house today? But when you understand that God works all things out for your good, you don't allow situations that you may have not known about to knock the wind up out of you, because you know that God is still in control. When the heartache comes or the disease comes, you don't give the devil the glory because you understand that God is still in control. When the devil tries to get on your back and the doctors don't know what to do, God will cause a ram in the bush to come by and speak a word on your behalf. I've come to tell you this morning that God has a way of getting your attention, because he has a purpose and a plan for your life, graduates. This is only the beginning. Yes, I know you had to write your thesis and you had to be able to learn hermeneutics and you had to be able to write a paper that seemed as if it would never end. You came in the rain. You came in the snow. You came when it was cold. But this is your day to let the devil know, in spite of everything you brought my way, I'm still standing. Oh, yes, I am. When we think about the fact that God has set it up through Christ, that we are all joined together as one body, different gifts, different talents, hallelujah, different levels of faith and even anointing, but God has set it up that we all work together. He wants us to work together and understand that no matter my role, maybe an apostle, maybe I'm an evangelist, maybe you're a pastor, maybe you're a teacher, maybe you are a prophet, whatever your role, I don't have to tear down my sister or my brother in order to make me feel large. Come on, somebody up in the place. Because the fact of the matter is, all of us know how to praise God together. Come on. All of us know how to worship together. All of us can sit at the feet of the preacher together, but when it comes to celebrating one another, the enemy tries to come in and come in strong. But we are stronger united when we understand that it's never about you nor me, but it's always about God. So we're in this place this morning because we have come to celebrate what God is doing in your lives. We've come to let you know that we've got your back, that no matter what you go through, we're going to be here for you, that no matter what you face, we're going to help you face it, that no matter what you're trailing through, we're going to help you trail through it, because God has a purpose and a plan for your life, and there are people waiting on you to preach a word in season and out of season, but in order for you to get to them, you can't lose your fire. See, today is a day of great celebration, Dr. Archer, because we're also very excited. We're robed up. We're ready. We feel the presence of God. The anointing is in the house. We're ready to give God our final, our concluded yes. But the fact of the matter is, when I get home and I take the robe off, when I take the hat off, come on, somebody, when the cap is laid down, when the Bible is closed, when it's time for me to get in my prayer closet, I got to be able to still face some things that have been trying to tear me down. Oh, but I got to let the devil know, you're not going to take my fire. Yes, I've come here today. Yes, I'm robed up. Yes, I'm ready to be equipped and equipped. But you're not going to take my fire. And so in order for you to not let the devil take your fire, there are several things that you must do. The first is humble yourself. Come on, somebody.
Humble yourself before the mighty hand of God. Come on, scholars. And he will exalt you in due season. See, sometimes, I'm not going to talk this way because I don't want you to take it personal. Sometimes when we put the cap on and when we put the robe on, we automatically think it's our time. Come on, somebody. We're ready to grab the mic. We're ready to sit folks down and we're ready to preach. But do you know there is a process? Come on now. Just because you finish this level doesn't mean that you're ready to quite go to the next level. So you have to be willing to humble yourself before the mighty hand of God so that when it's time, you'll be ready. Come on now. If that means I got to preach in my mirror, I'll preach in my mirror in my own bathroom. If that means I got to talk to myself and encourage myself, I'll do that by myself. But I'm going to humble myself so that God knows that when he calls me, I'll be ready in season and out of season. Humility. See, when I humble myself, I can't lose my fire because I know without God I can't do anything. Come on, somebody. When I humble myself, I know that no matter how many balloons or cards they give me, or no matter how many accolades I get, I can't do nothing without Christ Jesus. Come on, somebody. See, when I humble myself, I know that it's not me that's preaching or teaching, but it's the Holy Ghost. When I humble myself, I know that even when there's pain in my body, and I feel like sitting down, it's God that stands up in me. When I humble myself, I give all glory to God. I give all praise to God. I let the devil know that you don't have no control over this situation. Matter of the fact, every single attack of the enemy, we bind it in the name of Jesus. When I humble myself, I can't lose my fire because I understand that the fire is shut up in my bones. And even if I tried to shut my mouth, God's going to raise it up. Humility. Humility. If I'm not going to lose my fire, that means I have to watch how I think. Come on, somebody. I don't want to ever think more of myself than I should. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. I want to be able to see myself the way that God sees me, but let my full confidence be in him. Come on now. You can have more degrees than a thermometer, but guess what? God is the one that is omniscient. Come on up in here. He's the one that I still got to go to in the morning and pray to. He's the one that I still got to seek his face in the morning and the noonday and the night. He's the one that I still cry to and say, God, I need you to help me. No matter what you get in life, you're still gonna call on the Holy Ghost. No matter how far you get in life, you still gotta call on the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost can give us power. The Holy Ghost can give us strength when we feel like crying and letting go. God says I'll wipe away every tear. When we feel like letting go of our dreams, God says, not so, baby. I'm gonna give you a dream that only I can accomplish. That is why you gotta be careful why you think. You gotta be careful when you let the enemy plant seeds in your spirit, because those seeds will turn into things that start to grow. And when it starts to grow, it'll start to manifest. And when it starts to manifest, you'll become a mess. Come on, somebody. So you gotta make sure that you're careful how you're thinking. So you gotta be humble. And you gotta watch how you think. And you gotta let God continue to renew your mind. Come on, Bible scholars. You gotta let him renew your mind, because you know the enemy works overtime on our minds, because he understands if I can work on their mind, then I'll get to their heart. Come on. If he tells you you're not gonna make it, then you think you're not gonna make it. And that's why you gotta surround yourself with people that are willing to pray for you. When you can't pray for yourself, you gotta surround yourself with people that are willing to wail on the wall. When you can't wail on the wall, you gotta be ready to surround yourself when accidents come and go and you have no clue. That is why you gotta be careful how you think, because what the enemy tries to do is he tries to get you to hate the one that has your deliverance in their hands. Come on now. He tries to get you to dislike the ones that have the power through Christ to set you free. Come on, somebody. That's why whenever the enemy is working on your mind, you have to take every argument or imagination and cast it down in the name of Jesus, so that no strongholds will be able to work against your mind. Because when strongholds work on your mind, they'll work on your heart. And when they work on your heart, they'll work on your spirit. And when they work all in your bosom, everything that the stronghold looks like, you'll begin to reflect. That's why you can go to some places that have nothing to do with one another, and everybody still think you mean, and everybody still think you nasty, because you haven't worked on your mind and your spirit. But that's why you gotta let the Holy Ghost get up in your mind and speak to you, and tell the devil to shut up, so that no matter where you go, your reputation precedes you. Come on up in this place. Is there anybody in the house that's going to let God work on your mind, that's going to get that mess out of your mind? You're not going to let the devil manipulate you no more. You're not going to let him mess you up no more. Matter of the fact, this is the day that you have decided that I'm going to walk out of here and I'm going to be a better minister. Oh yes, I am. I'm going to be a better daughter and a better son in Christ, because I'm going to get my mind fixed. So the text tells us that Christ himself, he gives the gifts. He said, I've given the gifts to them. Some of them are apostles. He says that some of them are prophets. Some of them are teachers. Come on. Some of them are evangelists. Come on up in this place. He says that I've come and I've given them the gift because I don't want them to be comparing themselves to one another. You know, for some of y'all that go on Facebook, you know how we do. We look at the Facebook pictures and we see everybody smiling and everybody profiling. But don't you know that's only a glimpse of a second of their time? We start to compare our lives to theirs. What kind of slap is that to the grace of God when we start to compare somebody else's life to how far God has brought us out? That's why you gotta be careful what you look at, apostles. That's why you gotta be careful what you teach, preachers. Come on up in this place. So we gotta be careful what we look at. See, the eyes are like the gates to the soul. Come on, somebody. You gotta be careful what you're blinking at. Come on up in this place. When you see something that is not of God, you need to be quick to flee and walk away. Because if the enemy can entice you, if he can get your attention, Eve, if he can cause you to think that you're going to have power because you bite this fruit, if he can cause you to think that you're going to have power because you're looking like you want it, you got to get to the place where you decide that I'm not going to let nothing in my spirit that's going to hinder me from moving forward in faith. I'm not going to look at nothing. I'm not going to gaze at nothing that's going to cause me to lose my fire, because God wants me to be obedient. God wants me to be holy. God wants me to be righteous. And I can't be righteous when I'm gazing at stuff that doesn't look like God, because we are the light of the world. We are the salt of the earth. And God has given us power to transform nations. God has given us power to deliver folks out of captivity. God has given us power to speak things that are not as though they were. God has given us power to turn our situation upside down. But I can't look at everything I want to look at. I can't go everywhere I want to go, because I got an anointing on my life. I got purpose on my life. There's a word in my belly that somebody's waiting on. And because of that, I can't do what I want to do. I got to do it God's way. So, he says, I've given you these gifts, but it's not for your glory. It's not for you to think that you're all that. I've given it to you because there are some saints that need to be equipped. The enemy is counting on us to lose our fire, because if we lose our fire, everybody that's waiting on the ministry that God has put in us will not get what they need. Come on, somebody. That is why not only do you have to remain humble, watch your thinking, and watch what you look at, you got to watch what you ingest. Come on, somebody. You can't take every word and say that this is what it is for my life. You got to be able to go to God and ask God, what is the next step? Where would you want me to go? What's the word that I have in my belly? What's my calling, God? Where should I go? Who should I connect myself to? Where should I walk this time? Where do you want me to work, God? Where is the vineyard, God? What do I need to do? A lot of times, we don't even listen to leadership, but God speaks through the leadership to give you a word, so you can't sit there and be planning to take over leadership. You gotta sit like a humble little mouse. Come on, somebody. You gotta pray morning, noon, and night, and cover the house of God with prayer. And this is why we got to be careful not to allow the enemy to cause us to speak things that are not of God, because there is power in your mouth. You can call some things that God never intended, because there's power in your mouth. You can call some things to take place that God never planned, because there is power in your mouth. Some of us, if we're not careful, we'll start calling the devil's work a confirmation. But I want you to know that you will know by God's spirit if it is God, based on his word. I heard you singing. You said the Bible stands. Well, if it stands in your life, let it stand when you walk out that door. Let it stand when you're in the dark by yourself. Let it stand when you're on your job. Is there anybody up in the house that has decided that this word's gonna stand all the days of my life? Somebody shout up in the house. So it tells us, he says to us, I've given you these gifts because I am expecting my people to work for the service of this ministry in the earth. I've given it to you because now you are mandated to make a difference. Come on, somebody. So that means that not only am I remaining humble and watching what I think and watching what I look at and watching what I ingest or say, but now I'm also allowing him to guard my heart. Come on, somebody. Oh, God, because I can't let anything get in my heart that's not of God. When I let corruptible things get in my heart, I start to hurt people that I love. Come on up in this place. If I'm going to be a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, if I'm going to have people interrogate me so I know what I'm talking about, come on up in this place. That means that I've got to be willing to let God take some things out of me that's been in there for too long. I don't know about you, but some of us have been dealing with some stuff that came from our childhood. Some of us have been dealing with some stuff that came from some adults in our lives. Some of us have been dealing with some stuff that should have been gone a long time ago. But guess what? This is your day and this is your season to declare to the devil, I'm not going to let you take my fire. I'm not going to let you put out my fire. There are no fire extinguishers here. I'm not going to let you cause me to miss out on the Holy Ghost, but I'm going to stand firm, understanding that God has much more for me, understanding that God is going to bless me even when I feel broken. He's going to build me up even when I feel like I'm falling. coming. He's going to give me faith. Even when I feel like I'm hopeless, he's going to give me hope. He's going to minister to me in my mess. He's going to operate on me and open up my heart. He's going to give me power that causes me to preach. He's going to quench my thirst and cause me to not quit. He's going to make me righteous in the middle of the storm. He's going to give me strength when I feel like I'm swallowed up. I'm going to be tenacious. I'm going to take hold of his hands. He's going to give me understanding and victory because I win in God, and no demon shall be able to form a weapon that prospers against you. Oh, won't you stand on your feet and declare today that this is my season and my time. I'm going to give God the glory. I'm going to give God the praise. I'm going to lift him up because I've been gifted to equip the people. I've been gifted to equip the saints, and I'm not going to quit. I know you want to quit, not just for the graduates. I know you want to quit, but you're not going to quit. I know you want to let go, but you're not going to let go. I know you want to run away, but you're not going to run away, because the fire shall not go out. Touch your neighbor, say it won't go out. It won't go out. The devil wants it to go out, but it won't go out. The devil wants it to go out, but it won't go out. High five somebody and tell them it won't go out. Not today, not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, not next year. The fire won't go out, not ever. As long as God is on the throne, the fire won't go out. Somebody shout up in this place, let God know, I'm gonna hold on, I'm gonna hold on, I'm gonna hold on. Come on and praise him in the house. Come on and bless him in the house. Come on and magnify him in the house. The devil thought he had you, but you got away. He thought he was gonna knock you out, but you got away. Come on and bless him for yourself. Come on and praise him for yourself. Lift up your hands, oh ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, for the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Somebody praise him. Hallelujah. 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 Come on and praise him for yourself. Come on and magnify him for yourself. He brought you out. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Listen. This is your opportunity to let the devil know. You thought that you had me. You thought that I was going to give up. You thought that I was going to let go. You thought that you were going to knock me out. But touch your neighbor and say, I'm still standing. I thought I'd be knocked out, but I'm still standing. I thought I would have quit by now, but I'm still standing. I thought I was going to lose my mind, but I'm still standing. I thought I'd be dead by now, but I'm still standing. Touch your neighbor and tell them, you need to get up from where you are, because you're standing too. You thought it was over. You thought you would quit, but you're still standing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah. Listen. to take my seat. But let me just put this in your spirit. Stop giving the devil so much credit. Stop giving him so much credit. Stop speaking his name so much. Replace it. Tell somebody, replace it. Replace it with Jehovah Jireh, my provider. Replace it with Jehovah Shalom, my peace. Replace it with Jehovah Tiskanu, my righteousness. Come on up in this place. Replace it. And stop giving them so much credit. Come on and put your hands together. Let's celebrate these graduates once again. Praise him. Praise him. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Apostle said something earlier about how scripture won't apply to you if you don't walk in faith according to what it's requiring of you. Amen. And so listen. This word is provided to everybody, but not everybody has yet. Everyone has not yet received it. Amen. And listen, everyone, I want you to be seated, but I also want you to be prayerful as I'm appealing. Listen, this is what I want to tell you. Everyone in here at some point in time was a sinner. Everyone. We just don't all tell our story. Amen. We come dressed up as if we've always been this way. And this appeal is never meant to make anyone feel ashamed. Because we have all been at that starting point. We were born into iniquity. Amen? And I say that to say this. So desperately, myself and I am sure the graduates and also the pulpit, every believer in here wants you to know Christ. And it doesn't mean that once you know him, everything will be perfect. It is far from that. Because the devil is like a jealous boyfriend. Or for maybe the men, a jealous girlfriend. Where no matter how many times you tell him, he tries to keep calling. He tries to keep knocking on the door. He tries to keep giving you gifts of nothing. Come on. And I say that to say, if you say yes, I can't guarantee you that everything will be perfect, but what I can guarantee you is that everything will be in the hands of the perfecter. Amen? And so, the appeal right now is simply this. If you're not sure if you died right now, I don't want to scare you, I just want to check you. If you are not sure if you died right now, that you would go to heaven because you have never fully given your life to Christ, then this appeal is for you. And listen, I don't want you to be afraid, because I know sometimes as believers, we point the finger, we say, there she go again, there she goes again. He's coming back to the altar again. Listen, they're not God. We're not God. We're not Jesus. We didn't die on the cross for you. Come on. And some of us know you, and we still wouldn't do it because we are about ourselves. But listen, God is never about just himself because he sent his son Jesus. And that's what we're talking about when we say equip the saints. We want to equip you. He said earlier, we're going to receive from the woman of God by faith. So every believer, I need you to tap deep into your faith right now. We're going to receive somebody right now by faith through Christ. They're going to give their lives to Christ. So let's start praying right now. And whoever that person is or those persons, we need you just to come because we're going to pray with you. And today your life is going to change. Let's pray, saints. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
this is your time. This is your moment. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Amen. When praise the Lord. Says, hallelujah. Yeah. Amen.
To your will, Lord.
Amen. Amen. Is there another? Hallelujah. Is there another?
Yeah.
Come on and let's praise God for our brothers coming from the top.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Come on, praise him. Praise God like he's your family member. Hallelujah, Jesus. We have another sister coming. I feel your presence, God. There is an anointing in the house for release. Hallelujah. Come on and praise God. Hallelujah. Is there another? Is there another? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am so glad that you all came. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Praise the Lord.
Give your heart to Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. This is what I'm going to do. I want you to use my words, but your faith. Amen. And if there is another, but you are afraid and or ashamed to do so, or you don't want your family members looking at you because you don't want after this moment for them to be putting the gospel just straight down your throat. You're just worried about the day after. Don't do that to yourself. If you want to come, and I am talking to you, if you want to come, then you come. And you don't let the devil have any more control over your mind. You come. You come. You come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I want you to use my words, but your faith. Amen. Amen. And for that brother that did not come, but you knew you were supposed to come, guess what? Even in your seat, you can get it. You can get it. Amen. Dear God, thank you so much for sending your son Jesus, Christ, to die for me. I believe that I can be healed, I can be delivered, and I can be saved. Because of the blood of your son, Jesus Christ, that was shed on Calvary's cross. I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth that Jesus died for me. And because I believe he's washed my sins away, I am now saved. Because I believe I have the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit. Because I believe I am now your daughter. I am now your son. And I am now free. So God, even right now, I lift my voice and I say thank you. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for strengthening me. Thank you for delivering me. Thank you for now never leaving me, nor forsaking me. And God, I ask, because I made this commitment, every devil that is waiting on me, by the power of agreement and faith in this house, every demonic principality has been bound in the name of Jesus. And nothing, God, that the enemy tries to do against me is going to work. In Jesus' name, it is established. And every morning when I get up, I'm going to say to myself, yes, I am saved. Yes, I am free. Yes, I am delivered. And the devil's tricks will no longer work. In Jesus' name, you all are covered by the blood of the Lamb, and no weapon formed against you shall be able to prosper in Jesus' name.
Your life will never be the same. Don't be afraid of moving forward, and don't let the devil hijack your thoughts. Amen? In Jesus' name, God bless you. God bless you.
Counselor.
Praise the Lord. She's going to come down. Don't go anywhere. She's going to come down. She's going to give you a hug. If you came here with a church, go back to that church. But if you don't have one, tomorrow morning at 11 a.m., you could be here. Okay? You could be here. If you came with a church, go back with that church. Somebody look. Maybe that mother wants some prayer. Maybe the speaker want to pray for her. Somebody, she wants some prayer. Pray for her. It only take a minute, and then we'll finish with our graduation. Somebody to just stand and thank God. Look at them. They came with their children. Come on, thank God. Come on, come on. We ought to thank God. Come on, that's the epitome of the service. Come on, thank God. Come on, thank God. Hallelujah. Come on, I don't hear you thanking him. Come on, heaven is rejoicing. I say heaven is rejoicing. I say let it be done on earth as it is in heaven. Heaven is rejoicing. Hallelujah. I don't know who they came with, but if they didn't come with somebody with a church, it's okay. But if they didn't, Tabernacle, you get them. Amen. They came with a church. Let's don't steal. All right? Amen. But if they didn't, get them. Okay? Praise the Lord.
For the world today, above them there's no other. Jesus is the way.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is the answer.
Hallelujah. What a mighty word, amen. Hallelujah. Thank you very much. Praise God. Right from the beginning, she says, we're stronger united. Amen? We're stronger united. Hallelujah. Praise God. We just got to remain humble. Seek the face of God. Ask God to renew our minds. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All right? I'm going to invite these persons to the pulpit, Dr. William Denson, Dr. Mamie Green Archer, Dr. John, Dr. Elizabeth Myers, and Pastor Jacqueline Barksdale, as we proceed.
The Lord. Amen. God is good. Amen. And he's worthy to be praised. Amen.
Praise the Lord. While they're getting ready, they did make some CDs of her message. So after service, you can purchase the CD. Amen. Where's JR? He told me he was going to do it, all right? So he's doing it, right? And you're going to take care of it. You see, Missionary Clark, she'll be one that will have them. So you can get the message because you don't get it all just because you heard it here, right? You ought to take it home and play it again to put it in your spirit. Amen? And don't forget, while they're getting everything together, we're going to have summer school. So if some of you want to get a little taste of our institute, come out to summer school. Amen? They got a booklet. They have the classes. It's not going to be a full amount of the classes, but they're going to be something that will bless your soul. Amen? So you can come and get a taste of us, and if you like our food, you'll be back in September. Amen? Amen? Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Dr. Denson, it is an honor to present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017, who has completed one semester course of study.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have successfully completed a 12-week course of study according to our curriculum, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute and Seminary, I hereby recommend Dr. Mamie Archer that they may now receive their certificates.
Basic writing, Christian growth and development, faith, how to study the Bible, missions, music theory, voice, music theory, voice two, soul winning, Sunday school administration, and Sunday school administration two. Aletha Wilkins. Clarissa Bowman. Denson, it is my happy privilege to present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017 that have completed a one-year certificate course of study according to our curriculum.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have successfully completed a one-year course of study according to our curriculum, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute and Seminary, I hereby recommend that they may now receive their certificates. Dr. Mamie Archer.
Advanced writing, Bible survey, English, Holy Spirit and His gifts, intercessory prayer, prophetic, psychology, public speaking, spiritual warfare, thesis writing, the book of Acts, the book of Daniel, the book of Romans, the book of St. John's, the book of Revelation, and the Tabernacle of God.
Teresa Patterson. Singleton. Odessa E. Ross. Thank you. Sophia Michael. Deborah Williams. Albert Andrew Sr. Patricia Sanders, our salutatory. Carolyn Shepherd. Dalton Egert. Keisha Fenton.
So he can get the picture, he's feeling a flash. So if you take your picture while he's taking his, they're not going to be able to get this picture. Okay, so please hold it to afterwards, then you'll get the pictures with them, okay?
Joseph Lewis.
Dr. Denson, it is a great honor to present to you the graduating class for the year of 2017 that represents our founder, Dr. C.R. Johnson, and has completed a 1-year certificate course of study according to our curriculum.
Amen. We must never forget Dr. C.R. Johnson. We must never forget the founder, the visionary of Community Bible Institute and Seminary. Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have graduated a one-year course of study of the class Evangelism, which we honor our founder with, as president of Community Bible Institute and Seminary, by the power invested in me, I now hereby recommend that these students may receive their certificates in evangelism.
Evangelism. Netta Austin. Our questionnaire. Carolee McLaughlin. Our questionnaire. Jones. Emma and Joseph Smallwood, husband and wife. Thank you. Denson. It is my happy privilege to present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017 that have completed a two-year certificate course of study according to our curriculum.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have successfully completed a two-year course of study according to our curriculum, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute and Seminary, I hereby recommend that these students may now receive their certificates. Dr. Mamie Archer, you may now call their names.
General Bible, postgraduate studies, and teachers training. James. Janice Thomas.
Wonderful brother, and before he leaves us, we're gonna get his name right.
Diane Nichols. Yvette E. Stewart.
Give her a hand clap. She's not even supposed to be out of the hospital, and she decides to walk. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's encourage her. Come on.
Present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017 that have completed the undergraduate course of study and have earned 128 credits according to our curriculum and is awarded the bachelor's degree from the Community Bible Institute and Seminary.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have successively completed 128 credits according to our curriculum, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute and Seminary, I hereby recommend that these students may now receive their baccalaureate degrees.
Bachelors of Religious Education and Bachelors of Theology. Jacqueline B. Houston. Yeah. Miguel Collymore. Jacqueline B. Houston. Thank you. Denson Johnson. Barbara Smith. Can.
Moments like these that students travel in their wheelchairs, sometime and not ordinarily not feeling good, but on top of ordinary, extraordinary not feeling good, and still able to make it. And she says, I don't want to receive my degree sitting down. I want to stand up. Thank you.
Dr. Denson, it is an honor to present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017 that have completed the graduate programs and have written a 25,000 word thesis according to our curriculum for the master's degree to be conferred upon them from the Community Bible Institute and Seminary.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have completed successfully our master's program and they have written a 25,000 word thesis, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute, I hereby recommend that the master's degree be conferred upon them with all of its rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Dr. Mamie Archer, ye may now call their names.
Master of Christian Counseling, Master of Divinity, Master of Theology, and Master of Religious Education. Charles. John Rowe, our valedictorian. Xavier Sanders. Helen John. Dr. Denson. It is a great honor to present to you the graduating classes for the year of 2017 that have completed the doctoral programs and have written a 50,000-word thesis according to our curriculum for the doctoral degree to be conferred upon them from the Community Bible Institute and Seminary.
Dr. Mamie Archer, seeing that these students have successfully completed our doctoral program and written a 50,000-word thesis, by the power invested in me as president of Community Bible Institute, I hereby recommend that they may now receive their doctoral degrees to be conferred upon them with all of its rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Dr. Mamie Archer, ye may now call their name.
Doctor of Christian Education and the Doctor of Divinity. Rachel Blackmon. Julia Choi Clark.
You're going to notice something. Their hats are different. They no longer graduate. Amen. They no longer turn their tassels. You can see that their tassels are already set. They're doctors. Nothing deep about salvation, no matter what people say. There is nothing deep about redemption, no matter what people say. But we pray that these doctors would be able to stand up against the Imanis, against the other people with respect, and be able to show through them the scripture and their experience with the Lord Jesus Christ, that they would turn their lives to God. We are losing the battle in courts. We are shouting in church, but we're losing the battles in courts. But we pray that these doctors would be able to go to the lawyers in the courts and lay down the laws of apologetics and defeat them on their own ground. Give God some praise. Give God some glory. Amen. I don't know who's going to end it. That's not for me to do. Are we finished?
Dr. Denson, it has been recommended that our speaker for the hour receive this degree. It has now been confirmed that Reverend Arlise Carson received a Doctor of Divinity. Amen.
She's deserving, isn't she? She's deserving. I'm just saying this and I'm going to get out the way. Oh, they got it on there. The message that she preached today, they have the CDs ready. Amen? So when you leave, they'll direct you. I don't know. I'm just the president. Okay? I don't know. All right? But they'll direct you and keep that in your mind. They'll let you know where they are so you can purchase them as you go out. Okay? Okay, so everybody stand. We're going to ask that you do us a favor. In honor to the graduates, please don't leave because you will jam up. If I'm not mistaken, they're going to open up all the doors after we leave. You could go out either way. But give the graduates their due and let them march out first as you shout for them and give God glory for their day today. Amen. Start the benediction out with grace and peace be multiplied unto you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. May the grace of God, the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, and the Word of God keep you throughout your lives. And may the angels be encamped round about you. And may you draw a bloodline that the devil can't cross. In Jesus' name, amen.